Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of a capacity planning, guys. Guys, I'm saying clearly in the initial only. So this topic, in each and every book or even on YouTube, we are having multiple ways, guys. So I don't know exactly which answer is correct. So in our college PPTs, I found this exact theoretical part. So I wrote it, guys. So that is the thing, guys. So please, if you are following any other, your faculty told any other capacity planning steps and all those things, please follow them, guys, because it will be better, right? Yes. So I'm following this. So if you want to follow along with me, you can follow this also. Anything will work. Okay. Yes. So basically, what is this capacity planning, guys? Okay. So first of all, we all know that these cloud services and all those things, there will be multiple users using it, right? So multiple members might access the same thing. So let us take the example of website again. Okay. So there will be multiple users coming at the same time of it. A particular moment of time like that, there might be some issues, right? Yes. So to avoid those issues, we should have a clear idea about how many visitors will come, what they will request. We need to have some idea, right? Yes. So based on that, we can plan the things, right? So that concept is nothing but capacity planning. So basically, how much capacity your website can hold. So basically, how much traffic can your website hold or sustain is nothing but your capacity planning. The concept is that only, guys. Okay. Yes. So it refers to the arrangement in which organizations or teams match employees together with the needs of a project. Okay. So this definition might not sound that much clear, right? Yes. So let us now go to the second definition. Second definition will give you a clear idea, guys. Okay. So capacity planning is basically developing a strategy that guarantees your infrastructure can support resources on demand. So basically, if there is a high traffic, your system will not face any issues because you have already planned for those things, right? Yes. So that concept is a capacity planning. So you might be saying that, okay, so this sounds really interesting, but is this possible in cloud? Yes. The answer is yes, it is possible. So capacity planning in cloud. So in cloud computing, capacity planning is done at two levels. Okay. So basically, it could be done with respect to the user, guys. So you as a user or a developer, you can identify your capacity and you can inform your service provider that you will have this kind of traffic, this kind of patterns. So based on that, they will decide the things, guys. Okay. So at the first level, each consumer or customer of a cloud service does his own capacity planning. So basically, he will check his system. So basically, at how much capacity he is facing problems. So do he want to increase his capacity or decrease his capacity? Like that, he will be thinking and he will be deciding, guys. Okay. So at the second stage, at the second level, the cloud service provider analyzes the capacity requirement of all the consumers together and makes the ultimate overall. So basically, here you as a consumer, you will have your requirement. Whereas if this company is having hundreds of these kind of items, like these kind of providers, they are providing to hundreds of customers. So in that situation, they need to analyze each and every one of them, and even combinedly they should analyze, right? So that is the second level, guys. So that is done by your service providers. So they check individually as well as they check in combined, because even in combined, their systems should handle that capacity, right? Yes. Okay. So at the consumer level, you can divide into two groups, guys. So I told you level one is with consumers, level two is with service provider. Service provider will check with everyone's, right? Yes. At the consumer level, you can divide into two groups. So the first group will be IaaS, guys. So here it is infrastructure as a service, right? So if you recall, in infrastructure as a service, you can change some infrastructure facilities, right? So you can increase your RAM, you can do some modifications to your storage, you can do some kind of things. So here the customer or the consumer is having an open flexibility to change things, right? Yes. So at that moment, your service provider should have a huge control on it, else it will be a huge issue, right? Yes. So IaaS consumer generally plans and reserves a fixed capacity of resources. So basically, if he says that he needs 16 GB of RAM and currently he is using only 4 GB. And he told that at some moment of time, I need 16 GB. So at this time, the cloud service provider will keep 12 GB of RAM aside for him, right? Yes. So this kind of planning will be done, guys. So that is nothing but the capacity planning in simple words, okay? Yes. So this drives them to do their own capacity planning. That is the reason why they do these capacity planning combinedly. Okay. So, okay. Capacity planning, but only for the virtual resources they consume. Okay. Yes. So similarly, IaaS does this, guys. Okay. Whereas for a SaaS and PaaS, we will have some fixed components, right? So basically, you cannot modify it. So if you want to increase your plans, you will need to change the plan. So basically, they will say gold plan. So in gold plan, you are having 4GB RAM and 2-core processor. In let us assume silver, like downgrading silver, in 2GB RAM and how much did I say, guys? Okay, so this is 4GB RAM, okay, and 2TB hard disk, and here it is 2GB RAM and 1TB hard disk. Whereas a diamond, it is 8GB RAM and 4TB hard disk. So in this way, it is increasing, right? So you need to move the plans. So that is in the situation in both the SaaS and PaaS. Okay, consumers generate opt for a dynamically metriced resources used in the model. Okay, yes. So all these things will be controlled by SLA, guys. That is nothing but your agreement. Okay, the contract agreement between you and the customer and the service provider. Okay, yes. Okay, so this whole thing can be done in 3 different steps, they say, guys. So the first step is nothing but understanding the demand or analyzing the demand. So the step name is nothing but determining the expected demand. So the capacity planning process, the service provider must carefully examine the expected overall resource usage pattern as they vary over the course of period. So basically, you cannot say that at this moment of time you will have a high traffic, at this moment of time we will not have traffic. We cannot say, right? So that is the reason why always these capacity planning so will be done based on the user requirement. So basically, the consumer will say, I want this much of things, are you ready to provide? So basically, the cloud provider will say yes, and they will be providing. So in this way, these capacity plannings will be done, guys. So it will be done both on the consumer side as well as the service provider side. Okay, yes. So based on those things, they will determine what they want. Okay, yes. So once they understood some demand, so after that they will be doing some analysis. So analyzing the current response to the load. So basically, based on your current speed, you will generate some users. So these users will judge whether the capacity is holding properly. So you told that for 100 users, the website will run 100% perfectly. Whenever it increases 200, it will become some slow. When it crosses 500, it will be damn slow. So in that way, they told means they will be checking, they will be testing it at least once, right? Yes. So that kind of analysis will be done here. So analyzing the current response to the load. So the next service provider must analyze the avoidance resource capacity of this their system and how the application responses to the load with the current capacity. So any requirement for can be identified. So basically, if it is not working properly even for 100 users, you will increase your system capacity some more. So they will be sending you the requirement that it is not sufficient, you need to upgrade your plan. So in that way, you will be upgrading your plan. Okay, yes. So at the end, the last step will be the knowing the value of the system. Okay, so finally, the service provider must be aware about the value of the system to the business. So to know when they are adding more capacity to the provider and when it is done. Okay, yes. So basically, whenever any kind of modification is done, so basically their billing amount or the financial requirement will also increase. So that is the reason why always the admins and all those persons will keep an eye on this. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about this capacity planning, right? Yes. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the load balancing, guys. So we'll be discussing about multiple ways in which the load balancing is also done. Okay, yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.